Hey, what's up, ladies and gentlemen? LCD here, and today I'm going to be giving you all a quick little guide here for the Yuliana set, which is a new set added to Monks in patch 2.3 of Diablo 3 Reaper of Souls. So what we're going to go ahead and do here, start up a private game and get you guys in the know-how about this set, why it is good, and how to use it to its maximum potential. Now, there are two different versions of this particular build, one of which is called the no-crit build, and then there's another one which is the crit build. Today, I'm going to be showing you the non-crit version of this particular build, and when I show it to you, you might freak out if you've never seen this build before, but it'll all make sense once we get through everything that we need to discuss. So first up, let's go ahead and go over the particular build itself. This is called the Exploding Palm build. It is made possible by this new set called Yuliana's set that was introduced in patch 2.3. And the two set bonus is every third hit of your spirit generator applies Exploding Palm. The four set piece is your seven-sided strike deals its total damage with each hit. And your six set bonus is your seven-sided strike detonates your Exploding Palm. Now, I want to preface this by letting you guys know that there are a lot of key items that you have to have to make this build really, really work. So this build does require a lot of items, a lot of farming. I am on Season 4 right now, and one of the key items that is required for this build is in the season-only item. So if you guys are playing non-seasonal right now, you might want to start playing some seasons so you can get access to these cool-looking legendaries that are only exclusive to Season 4. So the way this build works is that you want to apply Exploding Palm. And one of the key things that allows us to apply Exploding Palm so quickly is our Spirit Generator. So any Spirit Generator in the game for Monks will apply Exploding Palm on the third hit. So because of that, we're able to detonate every single target with Exploding Palm on them by using Seven-Sided Strike, which is another one of our abilities of our set pieces. Your Seven-Sided Strike deals its total damage with each hit and detonates your Exploding Palm. Now, Seven-Sided Strike is not going to be really our main damage dealer in this particular build. It's really going to be Exploding Palm. And even though we're applying Exploding Palm with our Spirit Generator, we still want to have Exploding Palm on our hotbar because it tells our set bonus that we want the damage to be cold damage from our impending doom rune, as well as get that extra 6,305% weapon damage as cold damage for the exploding palm effect, which we get through our generators. So the key items for this particular build, of course, are all six pieces of Yuliana's. You'll see why we can't use the Royal Ring of Grandeur in this particular set, because of the fact that we're using Focus and Restraint. This is a huge key factor to this particular build because of the way the build works, which I will show you guys how the build works here once we explain everything. So Focus and Restraint, very, very important. The next key component of the build is called the Lion's Claw. It's a new Season 4 only legendary, which makes our seven-sided strike perform an additional seven strikes, essentially just doubling the damage of seven-sided strike. So you can see here it does 5,677% weapon damage over seven strikes. Well, because of our four-piece set bonus, we're dealing 5,677% weapon damage for each hit of seven-sided strike. Double that by another 7, that's 14 strikes, you're dealing, you know, crap tons of damage, which is really, really good. Essentially just doubling the damage of 7-sided strike. The next piece we need is the Fist of Aturso. I probably butchered that name, but who cares? This makes Exploding Palms on death damage increase by 75 to 90%, and I rolled 90%, it goes all the way up to 100. Now you must put both of these weapons in your weapon slots. There is no room in the Kanai's Cube for either of these legendary passives, and again, we'll get to that here in a little bit. Another key item to this build is the this new belt that they added in 2.3 for Monks, which causes our seven-sided strike to grant us up to 3.5% damage reduction for 7 seconds. This is really, really good, and you'll see why it's really good for the greater rifts. Now, this build basically has no damage. As you can see here, I have 295,000 damage total. You're probably thinking, wow, this guy is crazy. He's never going to be able to do any type of rifts or anything like that. But you would be completely wrong, and I will get to that here in a little bit. I will show you guys the power of this build once you finally get it going. Next up, we have The Bracers, a new legendary for monks. Exploding Palms on Death Explosion applies Exploding Palms. So this is really good, just in case you're going to be spamming the crap out of Seven-Sided Strike. Cooldown reduction is a very, very key component to this particular build. So you'll see that we'll be able to spam Seven-Sided Strike as much as possible. So these Bracers allow us to not have to apply Exploding Palm more regularly. If something dies with Exploding Palm on it, that creature is going to apply Exploding Palm to everything else around it that it died around. So that means we have more uptime on Seven-Sided Strike, which is really good. But that is all of our particular gear. The last thing we need to cover is the amulet. Hellfire Amulet is really good for this particular build. I'm using the Mythic Rhythm passive. It's a really good roll. I could go a little higher on the crit damage, but I ran out of the Death's Breaths on season, so I guess could go reroll that a little bit better. But Mythic Rhythm passive is really good for this build. You could also get the Near Death Experience or Harmony. Anything that is required for this build, passive-wise, is really good for on the Hellfire Amulet. Mythic Rhythm passive is just a really, really good bonus, because if you don't know what Mythic Rhythm does, every third hit from our Spirit Generator increases the damage of our next Spirit Spender by 40%. So that would be our only Spirit Spender on this build is Seven-Sided Strike, or I guess if you're spending spirits on Mantra of Salvation, then I guess that would work too, but you're mostly damaged. Your Spirit Spender is going to be Seven-Sided Strike. Now let's go ahead and get to the abilities themselves. So the mainstays for any build for monks right now are Dashing Strike. Dashing Strike is really, really good. I'm using the Blinding Speed rune, which gives us 40% chance to dodge for 4 seconds. You'll see why that's very, very important in the higher greater rifts, that our survivability is very, very important for this build. So just keep that in mind. Next up, we have Mantra of Salvation. This is really good because it gives us the dodge chance as well. You and your passive allies also get the resistance increase. It's really good. If you're finding that you're not dying as much, you're just doing speed farming or something like that, you go Mantra of Conviction with Annihilation, which gives you the movement speed increase and things like that. Next up we have Epiphany, also really key to this particular build, using the Desert Shroud rune, which gives us 50% damage reduction while it is active, and Epiphany lasts for 20 seconds. Where is my family? So yeah, 50% damage reduction, very, very good. Anything that you can get defensively for this build is going to be amazing. Next up, we have our key component of the build, a Seven-Sided Strike. Again, your main damage isn't going to be coming from Seven-Sided Strike. It's going to be coming from the explosions that Seven-Sided Strike is proccing from Exploding Palm. Next up, we have our Spirit Generator. Now, most people, it doesn't really matter what Spirit Generator you use. If you want to go for damage, you go Way of the 100 Fists with the Assimilation Rune, which increases your damage for every enemy that you hit with this move. So that's really good. I like to use Deadly Reach with Scattered Blows because it makes it really easy to apply Exploding Palm. If you're doing speed farming, you can use Fists of Thunder with Thunderclap or anything. Any rune really doesn't matter. But Fists of Thunder is really good for farming. Speed farming, anyways. And last but not least, you need to have Exploding Palm on your bar. Now, you are never, ever, ever, ever going to click Exploding Palm with this build. The only reason we have it on our bar is because it tells our set bonuses that we want the impending Doom Rune to proc as our element modifier for the set piece. So when I use my third hit of my Spirit Spender, that third hit is going to apply Exploding Palm, and having Exploding Palm on my bar is going to make it sure that it applies the cold version of an impending Doom Rune on our targets. So that's very, very important to know. Going on to the passives, Beacon of War. Cooldown reduction is very, very important for this build, like I said earlier. So having Beacon of War, or Beacon of Yatar, excuse me, is very, very important. Next up, Harmony. Very important for any build on monks right now. Harmony is just the best defensive passive in the game. It's a must-have. Sixth Sense reduces all physical damage taken by 25%. This is also really, really good. Near-death experience. Very good survivability. Allows you to not die, especially if you're doing, you know, greater rift farming or greater rift pushing. The more time you can save by not dying, the better. So that's pretty much our entire skills list that you'll need for this build. Now, if you don't like running Mantra of Salvation, another really good ability to run if you're doing those super high greater rifts is Inner Sanctuary with the Forbidden Palace rune. Inner Sanctuary, if you don't know, reduces the damage, all damage taken by 55% for every ally that's in the circle. And if you use the Forbidden Palace rune, they take 30% more damage, and their movement speed is reduced by 80%. So it's very, very good for those higher greater rifts. It's not that good for speed farming, because everything is just dying so quickly that it's on a 20-second cooldown, so you're not going to have that opportunity to use it that often. But if you're in those super high greater rifts, you're spending more than 10 or 20 seconds on a single elite pack, then yeah, it's going to be really good. But for now, we're running Mantra of Salvation. Now, as for our Arcanized Cube, we have another three important items that are key to this build. First of those is Flow of Eternity. Reduces the cooldown of Seven-Sided Strike by 60%. Very, very key component of this build. You can actually get by without this, but you'll find that if you're doing higher greater rifts or, you know, speed farming, it becomes a really pain to wait for Seven-Sided Strike to come off cooldown. So using Flow of Eternity as our weapon passive here is very, very important. A lot of people would say, why aren't you using the Furnace? 50% damage against elites. And you'll see why Furnace really isn't that great for this build. Flow of Eternity is crucial. Next up, we're using Leoric's Crown. Now, Leoric's Crown is really good at the start of this build. Let's say you're speed farming or trying to find gear or whatever. But once you hit the Greater Rift level 50 plus, you're going to want to use these new bracers. The Spirit Guards, which causes our Spirit Generators to reduce all damage taken by 40% for 3 seconds. So every single time we hit our Spirit Generator, we're getting that 40% damage reduction, which is really good. So if you find that you're dying a lot, put on the Spirit Guard passive. If you need the extra cooldown reduction like I like to have, I use the Leoric's Crown. Next up, the most important part of this build, for this version of it anyways, this is the non-critical hit version of the build, which means that we want as least amount of crit chance as possible because of this ring right here called Broken Promises. After 5 consecutive non-critical hits, your chance to critically hit is increased to 100% for 3 seconds. So every single time we attack, blah, 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 we do 7-sided strike. Every single one of those 7-sided strikes is going to crit for 100% crit chance for the 3 seconds that proc is active. So as you can see here, I have 5% crit chance. And that's just the base crit chance that we get for creating any new character in the game. So none of my gear has crit chance on it. And the reason why this is because of this ring right here. We get all the crit we need from the Broken Promises rune. Because we're only going to be using 7-sided strike when it comes off cooldown. So having any of the extra crit is really not that important. Crit damage is really good to have on your gear, obviously. You still want crit damage. But crit chance, you want to avoid. So if you have a bunch of Paragon points, do not put your Paragon points into crit chance if you're using this particular version of the build. As far as Paragon points go, you do want to put, as you can see, I'm only at 284 Paragon points. I started the season really, really late. Put everything into movement speed and then dexterity. Maximum spirit is pretty much useless for this build. Offense, put everything into cooldown reduction, then crit damage, then attack speed, avoid crit chance. Defense, everything into life regeneration, because this build really lacks life regen. So any type of life regen you can get from your Paragon points or your gear is very crucial. So life regen, resist all armor, life percentage. And then you want to go for area damage, then life on hit, then resource cost reduction, then gold find. Gold find's useless or whatever. Resource cost reduction is not that important because the only thing that we're going to be spending is... 7-sided strike, which we always have spirit with this build anyway, so it really doesn't even matter. So that is the build in a nutshell, Jill, ladies and gentlemen. For my legendary gems, I'm using the Bane of the Stricken, Gooptek of Swiftness, and Bane of the Trapped. Bane of the Trapped is really, really good. It's like the best gem in the game. It gives you that passive damage bonus to everything that you're doing. Gooptek of Swiftness we'd like to use for the cooldown reduction mostly. The attack speed really isn't that useful, but the cooldown reduction is very, very important. Bane of the Stricken, you don't really need for this particular build if you're doing lower level rifts, or if you're doing speed farming. If you're doing speed farming or those lower level greater rifts, you can use Bane of the Powerful, because you're just going to be one-shotting everything. So having all that extra damage bonus for, you know, 30 seconds, 40 seconds, a minute is going to be really good. But if you're doing super high greater rifts, Bane of the Stricken is a must-have. So, now that I've told you everything you guys need to know about this build, let's go ahead and actually do a visual test here. So we're going to do Greater Rift level 40 here, Torment 9. Just to be on the safe side, give you guys an idea about how this build works. Using dash and strike.
What you ask is impossible.
See how we just one-shot everything? Now you want to keep Epiphany active as much as possible.
That ability is not yet recharged.
Because Epiphany is going to give you that 50% damage reduction, which is kind of key to living. When you find that you're going to die or something like that, you know, use dash and strike to gain the increased bonus chance to dodge. Pop your mantra of a salvation to give you that extra bonus resistance for a few seconds if you need to. Now for 295 damage, I think we're doing this Greater Rift level 40 pretty well so far. What do you guys think? I think we're doing all right.
It cannot be done.
Now I did tell you guys that there was another version of this build that uses crit, and that's technically the best version of this build, but only at the super high level ends of gear. The non-crit version is actually the best version if you don't have, you know, super high gear. As you can see, nothing I have is ancient, my weapons suck. So the non-crit version of this build is going to be your best version for quite a long time until you still, you know, get a lot of ancient pieces, your weapons are really good, you know, you maximize your rolls on your gear. That's when you're going to start finding that the crit version of the build is really good. When I say crit version, I mean crit chance. This is the non-crit chance version. But if you can stack up to about 45 to 50% crit chance with ancient levels of gear, that's when it becomes really good. But for now, the broken ring of promises is what you really want to be running.
Break beneath the endless tide to use that ability.
Because everything you do, L14 hits of 7-sided strike are going to crit. Especially if you time it right, get all your blocks in order, it's going to just blow everything. Now, the reason why cooldown reduction is so important for this build is because everything just comes off cooldown quicker. Dashing strike, which is really important. 7-sided strike, which is the key component of this build and the reason why it works.
It is not ready yet.
See how quickly we're going through this level 40 rip? Now, obviously, I'm still... My gear is garbage. I'm still farming. I'm trying to level up everything. So, level 40 is kind of like my maximum right now. I could probably push level 45 close to 50, but for right now, I just wanted to give you guys an idea about how this particular build works. It's also very good at killing Rift Guardians quickly, which is what I love about it.
Your strength fails.
Your strength fails. Aw, man. I missed Exploding Pump.
I must wait to use that ability.
Now you're going to be wanting to make sure you keep using Dashing Strike pretty regularly, because that's going to be your main survival component to this build. It's just Dashing Strike. Gives you that 40% increased chance to dodge for 3 seconds. It's really good.
Over.
Purple lasers, I'm not scared about that. Now, what makes this build so cool particular is that when 7-sided strike is active, you have invincibility. Nothing is going to hurt you. So, for all those reflect damage minions that have the proc reflect damage, damage is nothing against you because you're always mashing 7-sided strike. And while 7-sided strike is attacking, you're taking zero damage. It's very, very cool. So you can see how quickly we cleared that rift. Very, very quickly. Alright, so let's go ahead and level up our gems here. Bane of the Trapped. Get that up to 40 if we can. No! Yay! Gemming of the Gemming in the name of the Lord. That's cute. Alright, everybody, that is the complete build in a nutshell. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, I'll be sure to try to answer them in the comment section below. Ooh, that's actually a focus or restraint. Let's see if we can get an ancient one. I don't have an ancient focus or restraint yet. No, it's not ancient. Poo-poo. Oh well. So, also, one last thing I forgot to mention is that cooldown reduction on everything. So get cooldown reduction on your shoulders, cooldown reduction on your gloves, cooldown reduction on your rings, and cooldown reduction should be on your lion's claw as well. Also, if you get a perfect roll on your fist of the Az, try to get cooldown reduction on this one as well. So if you can spare it, this is a garbage roll on this weapon, so I just got this before I made this video, so pretty garbage roll, but if you can get cooldown reduction on it, do it. Also, get exploding palm damage on the items that you can as well. You can see I don't have crit chance on my helm, so it allowed me to get a free slot for exploding palm damage. You can also get exploding palm damage on your boots, I believe. Yes, exploding palm damage is on your boots as well. Also, kind of try to avoid movement speed on your boots if you can. I have it on these ones because I forgot to take them off. But you don't need movement speed on your boots. Put all Paragon points in the movement speed up to 25%. And then after you get exploding palm damage on the gear that you can get it on, then start to get life regen on your gear. Because like I said earlier, life regen is very, very important for this build because this build lacks it a lot. So whenever you can pick it up in Paragon points or, you know, gear, do that. So I hope you enjoyed this video, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you all so much for watching. My name's LCD. I'll see you next time. Enjoy the monk.